I'm really excited about this topic. There's a lot that's been going on in the last 9 months plus, especially since the introduction of RISE, as well as what we're seeing in the market relative to the changes that are occurring, particularly as it relates to organizations that are going from SAP ECC to S4, but also how they're proceeding to underpin that transformation with an infrastructure transformation as well. So I'm going to ask Justin to review kind of the market dynamics and kind of what we're seeing at a high level. Chip's going to take us through the SAP support ecosystem and kind of tee that up as it relates to, you know, what we view as that ecosystem and the complexities associated with it. Then we're going to do a direct comparison between the hyperscalers as well as RISE. And the other thing and the final thing that we'll do is we're going to go through exact, you know, experiences that we've had with our clients in the past 12 months, in particular, evaluating all the different support models, sourcing strategies, and the specific outcomes that they drove to in the support models that they've chosen.
Before we jump into the topic at hand, really defining your cloud strategy related to SAP and the hyperscalers, et cetera, we thought it was important to first review some of the business and technology challenges that many organizations and a lot of our clients and most of our clients are facing that really bring this topic to life and make the topic relevant today and certainly into the future. The other thing that's interesting is we're also seeing at the same time software OEMs like SAP, quote unquote, embrace the hyperscalers and leveraging the hyperscalers to be a meaningful part of their respective digital transformation journey and path to the cloud as well. And so what that leaves organizations with is a lot of decisions in terms of how they're going to, you know, procure their software licenses, et cetera, when they're going to do it, the model in which they're going to do it. And we bring this down to SAP and the specific ECC to S4 journey. One of the most important decisions is, am I going to go perpetual, stay perpetual, or am I going to go with RISE?
So what we found is there are four primary options as it relates to your support, where you want to land from a support model perspective. There's do-it-yourself, there's do-it-for-me, there's a professional model, and then there's the SAP RISE model.
How this process feeds into informing your business case is absolutely critical, because what we're seeing is folks are getting a little bit blindsided with how their process and the journey is informing the timing of the business case. And to make sure that you've got complete alignment with respect to your understanding of the offerings, the cost of those offerings, how financially, you know, the allocation between capital and expense is going to occur in order to inform the business case. And some folks are getting flat-footed with some of the changes that we've outlined here today.